Ready for action. Playing against the Paynes family. Bonnie, Suzanne, Glenn, Wendy, and Sharon. On your marks. Let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Ray Cohn.
Thank you very much, my friend. Hello, Mealy family. Welcome, Payne family. Thank you very much. It's a special day. Why? Just because it is a special day. Every day is special when we tape because we try to pick out of our audience a wonderful family that will be on the show the day that we tape. So if you're in the area, please come down and be a part of this wonderful overflow crowd who gave me such a wonderful standing ovation here today. Thank you for that. And now it is time to introduce our returning champions. They have displayed great character, the Mealy family. Dan, how are you, my friend?
Yeah, how you doing?
Last time you were on the show, you fell short for the big money. Who'd you bring today to help you do it?
My beautiful wife, Anne.
Yes, Anne.
Tongue tied.
Good to see you.
My sister-in-law, Jeannie.
Hi, Jeannie. Hi, Ray.
My brother-in-law, Stephen.
Ray. Hi, Stephen.
And my other sister-in-law, Chris.
Hi, Chris.
Hi,
it's good to have you back on the show. Here is your opponent, the Paynes family. Hi, Bonnie.
How are you?
I'm doing great.
Thank you.
You know, we're awfully happy to have you on the show.
Thank you. We're thrilled to be here. We just better win.
Well, I wish you luck. Who did
we'll
you bring
have
to
fun.
Help? Well, you'll have fun indeed, I can promise you that. But who did you bring to help you win?
This is my seductive sister.
Seductive?
Suzanne.
Ooh, seductive Ooh. Suzanne. And?
And my Hello. Sassy sister, Sharon.
Sassy Sharon.
Hi there.
And
my winsome daughter, Wendy.
Hello, winsome Wendy.
Hi.
And my gentle son, Glenn.
Hi, Ray.
How you guys doing?
Welcome to Family Feud. I say it's time we play the feud. Let's go. Come on, Dan. Let's go, Bonnie.
First family to 300 is going to play for the 5,000. Here we go. We ask 100 people this question. We put the top 7 answers on that board. You try to find the most popular. What's the worst thing that could happen just as company is about to arrive for dinner? Bonnie.
Burn the roast.
You burn that roast. Number one answer. Think of a steel ball. Back with your family. Suzanne. How you doing?
Hello. I would say that the guests don't come.
The worst thing that could happen just before they arrive for dinner is that they don't arrive.
That they fall through.
Okay, they fall through. Show me a...
No company. Sorry.
I think we got it, Suzanne.
Okay.
I think I understood it the first time.
Okay,
but I would appreciate so much that
okay.
you continued to give me answers. Show me. Fall through. Don't show. Ain't coming.
That was good, though.
You're pretty lucky because you gave three answers and you only got one strike. So, all right. It was an amazing thing. Sharon?
Yes.
Let me just say now, are your sisters?
You bet.
Now, somebody told me something wonderful about this family. You have how many children among you, among the sisters? Adopted. How many adopted?
11 adopted.
You adopted 11 children.
Yes.
Legally took them.
Many, many others.
And you have many others indeed?
Many others.
So 11 adopted.
11 adopted. Would you adopt me? You look like
you. Yes. Love to.
Love you.
Okay,
we'll
I like
you
that.
Home.
I like that. Okay. Sharon, that is a beautiful. I don't. I'm going to touch it here, but it's attached to your blouse. Look at this. How many diamonds are on that?
I don't know, but I love it.
Okay. All right. Well, it's lovely. Anyway, Sharon, we've got to get back to the question at hand. What's the worst thing that could happen just as company is about to arrive for dinner? Keep in mind, not showing ain't coming, not there, as already been given.
That my husband didn't show up.
That your husband doesn't show up, so you're there all alone.
Uh-huh.
Okay, maybe he's out looking for the people who ain't coming. Show me. Your husband is not there.
Oh!
Mealy family, you're going to get a chance to steal pretty early if wonderful Wendy, don't be nervous.
No, not much.
You've got 6 answers on that board that you can give me answers from.
I would say that the kids start fighting.
Terrible when the
Terrible.
Kids start
Awful.
Fighting.
And it happens.
Good.
Let me see. The children fighting. No, it is not there. Well, all of a sudden, the Mealys are going to get a chance to steal. Chris, look at you. You think you know this, I can tell. What's the worst thing that could happen just as company's about to arrive for dinner?
What about
the husband and wife getting in a fight.
Okay, nice talking to you, Chris. All right, Steven.
I don't know. How about plumbing backs up?
Plumbing backs up? This is lovely at your house. Jeannie.
You yourself get injured.
It sounds like a commercial.
Clogged drains.
All right, Dan, there's a number of answers there, but you know what? There are six answers on that board to steal the money with.
I'm going to be brave.
You're going to go out on your own?
I'm going to go out on my own.
What do you say?
Power outage.
That there's a power outage. You've stolen $61 if we see no power. How about it? I'm surprised how few of these answers we really knew. Does anybody in the crowd know what might be one of the others? Bad weather, somebody said in the crowd. All right, let me see. Number three. Spill or drop the... Number four. Plumbing problem. There you go, Stephen. All right. Yeah, I guess that would be kind of embarrassing. Number five. Telephone.
Okay.
Number six. Stove or oven problems. Number seven. Unexpected company.
That's right.
We are going to come right back with a lot more fun with our questions. Don't you go away. Lipstick all over your face.
You have it.
Go. Good luck. The top five answers are on the board. Name something that's usually only big enough for a child to ride. We go to Anne.
A toy.
Let me see. A child's toy. Hold on, excuse me. The judge says, hold on. We need a specific answer, Anne.
A little car.
A little car. It is there. Three answers are more popular. Something that's usually only big enough for a child to ride.
A little rocking horse.
A little rocking horse. There it is, number three. You think of this deal. Now we come over to the Paynes family. Sharon, what do you say?
A stroller.
Okay. Yeah, it's tough to get an adult. You can try. Squeeze them in there.
Great answer.
And a stroller. Yeah.
That was a good answer, though.
It was a good answer, Sharon, and I love you. But
thanks.
Didn't make our survey.
I got one.
Wendy, you got one?
A tricycle.
Let me see. A tricycle. Yes. Glenn, what do you say, pal?
3 seconds?
No, I didn't say 3 seconds, Glenn. Glenn, are you, would you be an accountant or an engineer?
I'm a dentist.
A dentist? Okay, I was just guessing. Any man that had that many ink pens in his shirt pocket for no reason.
I'll move those up.
Oh, no, that's okay. But the question is something that's usually only big enough for a child to ride.
How about a merry-go-round?
Well, you know.
Okay.
You know, Glenn, it could be there.
She took mine.
You know what? You committed yourself. You ever feel like you just jump out there and you're all alone? I mean, the crowd wasn't with you. Your family didn't go.
It is a good answer.
Okay.
That's very good. We like good dance.
Really?
Yeah.
Do you really mean it?
It's up there.
Do you really mean it? Show me a merry-go-round. Didn't make it, Glenn. Okay. Okay, all right. They're going to try to steal. Bonnie, keep it rolling.
Say it again.
The question? Okay. Something that's usually only big enough for a child to ride. How many people think I'm not quite right? Thank you. The judge raised his hand.
Big enough for a child to ride.
Yes.
Baby roller skates.
No.
Now, wait a minute here.
Suzanne, wait a minute here.
Whole family's changing the rules.
I'm sorry.
You gave seven answers to the first question. She gives an answer. Everybody else says good answer.
No,
and then you say no.
Good answer.
Now, she's snorting over there. We've got her snorting again. We're all out of control. He said merry-go-round. You backed him up. She says roller skates. You scream no.
Little roller skates.
Little, that helps out.
Okay.
If it's little roller skates are there, you're still alive.
Okay.
But I'm telling you right now, you're probably not. Okay.
Oh, no. Okay.
I hope so. Show me itchy-bitsy roller skates. The bank is still yours unless they can steal. And Suzanne, try to control yourself. All right. Chris, whatever, be careful, because this girl could start snorting at any moment. Something that's usually only big enough for a child to ride.
A swing.
Steven.
A hobby horse.
Hobby horse.
A slide.
A pony.
I'm going to go with swing.
A swing.
You're going with a swing. You've stolen that bank from the Paynes family. If I see... Now, don't just lighten up. The game isn't over yet. See? A swing. No! The Paynes keep the bet. Was it Chris that said swing?
Yes.
See, that's who you listened to.
Was
probably the wrong.
Teacher.
Oh, you are a teacher.
She's a teacher.
Okay, so that would make her no. All right. Show me number two. A pony. How about that?
Oh, well.
Number five. A wagon. The feud's begun, and we're coming right back with a lot more fun. Don't you go away.
If you like
go into detail.
Welcome back to The Fued. Right now, the Paynes family has $73. The Mealy family, $61. We go with another face-off. Let's go. Come on, Sharon.
Hi,
Let's
Sharon.
Go, Gina.
Good luck.
Good luck. We're going to double the dollar value here. Put the top five answers on the board. Sharon, you're leaning way in. You're wanting to do this so bad. Name something people do for recreation on cruise ships. What do you say, Jeannie?
Swim.
Let me see. Swim. Steven, what do you say?
Shoot skeet?
Shoot skeet.
Yeah.
Wow. How about skeet shooting? Chris?
What about dance?
Yeah, they do that, don't they?
Don't they on that? They dance.
Yeah.
They do.
Show me the dance.
All right.
10 people said it. All right, Dan, what do you say?
About layout by the pool.
How about layout? Woo! Sunday. Think of a steel pane. And?
Eat.
Oh, well, if you've ever been on a cruise ship, you definitely eat. But it didn't make our survey, and the Paynes are going to get a chance to steal $102 if Jeannie can't tell me something people do for recreation on cruise ships. I think recreation was the key word there.
I say they do aerobics.
Yeah.
Yeah, good answer.
You're still alive if one of those answers is aerobics. No. So you're not still alive. We come to the Paynes family. What do you know about cruise ships? Something people do for recreation on cruise ships. Glenn.
How about play shuffleboard?
All right, Glenn.
Yes.
Wendy, same thing?
Shuffleboard.
And Sharon?
Be entertained.
They just be entertained.
I say gamble.
They gamble. Yeah. All right, it's okay. You can say it. You don't have to do it. Bonnie, you can go with any of their answers or write on your own, too. We'll get you that bank. What do you say?
I like those two down there. Shuffleboard.
Okay. For $102, show me shuffleboard. Yeah! Take it back. We did not know. Number four. Gamble or play card. You say that? And it covered a couple different ways. $175 for the Paynes family. The Mealys have 61. We go with another face off. Come on, Stevie. Good luck. All right, here we go. Get ready, Wendy, because he doesn't play around.
Okay.
The dollar value is tripled, and the top four answers are on the board. We ask 100 people, name something you might ask someone to do to your back. Stevie.
Massage it.
How about... Well, let me just ask it one more time. Name something you might ask someone to do to your back. Steven says, massage it. Number two, one answer is more popular. Something you might ask someone to do to your back. Something.
Scratch it.
All right, show me. Scratch it. Number one. Piece of a steal. We come over to the Paynes family. Glenn, your family can win if you can give me one of these, if you can finish up with these two answers.
How about, well, how about crack it?
Show me crack your back. What do I know? What do I know? Crack my back. Bonnie, do you realize if you give me number four, you're the champions of Family Feud, you're gonna play for $5,000? What is it?
If you're very sunburned, you have someone put lotion on the back of you, right?
I am sunburned, and you just smacked me on my back.
I'm sorry.
All right, for the game, you show me rub lotion. Mealy's are still alive. What do you say, Suzanne?
Walk on it?
You ask somebody to walk on your
back.
Yeah,
you adjust it by walking on it.
You do. That's the way.
Maybe.
This is a nice family. Okay, you're going to play for $5,000 if somebody would ask you to walk on their back.
Really,
family,
so
you'll win the game if you can steal if Sharon doesn't know.
Sharon.
What is it?
I don't know.
Take a guess. Number four, something you might ask someone to do to your back. What is it? 3 seconds.
Rub it.
To rub it? It's already up there. Try again, quickly. You can do it. Okay, don't say anything. Neely family, now Chris thinks she knows this. Listen to the question. Name something you might ask someone to do to your back.
Wash it.
To wash it.
That's it.
Steven?
Wash it.
Wash it.
Wash it.
Wash it.
Tickle it. All right, just to kind of throw you off there, Dan. It's either they said tickle and wash. There is one answer. If you give it to me, you've stolen the entire game and are champions one more time. What do you say?
Wash it.
If number four is wash it, you've won this game. If not, it is the Paynes. Show me wash it. Yeah! Don't you miss it.
Like so many.
Your family wins the $5,000. Give me 15 seconds on the clock, please. Good luck, Dan. We ask 100 women, name the part of your body you think is ugly.
Breast.
Something most people don't clean well enough.
Bathtub.
The hour when most stores open.
7.
An occupation that uses a shovel.
Gardener.
A nut found in nut bowls.
Walnut.
Turn around here, Dan. We ask 100 women what part of your body you think is ugly. You said the women said their breast. Our survey said none, Dan. Every woman thinks they look like Bo Derek. Okay. Something most people don't clean well enough. You said bathtub. Our survey said 12. The hour when most stores open, you said 7 a.m. Survey said?
I work at a grocery store.
Oh, you do?
Yes.
What time's it open?
7 a.m. About 24 hours, to tell you the truth.
Thank you, Dan.
Thank you very much.
An occupation that uses a shovel, you said? A gardener. Our survey said? 10. All right. A nut found in nut bowls. You said the popular? Walnut. Our survey said? 25. 47 points. Cover those. Go back to the family. All right, we're going to leave a little work for your brother-in-law. Stephen, my friend, I want you to look straight ahead. There's a lot of number one answers up there. In fact, I believe every number one answer is sitting there for you, my friend. Give me 20 seconds on the clock, please. You can be a hero. You need 153 points. Clear your mind and give me these answers. Remember this. We ask 100 women this question. Name a part of your body you think is ugly. Quickly.
Toes.
Something most people don't clean well enough.
Kitchen.
The hour when most stores open.
9.
An occupation that uses a shovel.
Ditch digger.
A nut found in nut bowls.
Walnut.
Try again.
Almond.
Turn around. You need 153 points. We asked 100 women, what part of your body do you think is ugly? You said? Your toes, your tootsie witsies. Our survey said? Number one answer was feet. That's why a lot of women wear shoes, just to cover those ugly toes. I know a lot of women have 7, 8 toes on one foot. Something most people don't clean well enough, you said? Their kitchen. Our survey said? 0. Teeth, number one answer. Something a little more personal. The hour when most stores open, you said? 9 a.m. Our survey said? 45, the number one answer, 9 a.m. Occupation that uses a shovel, you said? A ditch digger. You laugh? Our survey said? 28, the number one answer. Comes down to the final question, a nut found in nut bowls, you said? An almond. If 44 people said almond, you got $5,000. Our survey said? what was the number one answer. You get $5 a point, giving you $805. Come out here and hug us. The Mealy family, still the champions, and we're coming right back. Please, don't go away.
Oh, well.
This week, get 23 portraits free at Sears Portrait Studio. That's 23 free portraits. One 10 by 13 wall portrait, free. One 5 by 7, free. Five wallet size, free. And 16 portrait petites, free. 23 free portraits. Free with your purchase of Sears $14.95 package. Pretty nice, huh? But hurry, Sears Portrait Giveaway can't last forever. Buy our 14-piece portrait package and get 23 additional portraits free this week at Sears.
You are about to see the most important words in headache and pain relief in 100 years. Motrin IB, no prescription needed. The doctor-recommended pain reliever in Motrin is now available in non-prescription strength Motrin IB. One Motrin IB is as effective as two regular strength Tylenol for relief of pain and gentler on your stomach than aspirin. New Motrin IB, tablets or caplets, doctor-recommended pain relief.
Anthony's back is killing him.
He's staying with me.
Now will Suzanne kill him with kindness?
It's like that movie, Whatever Happened to Baby Jane? And I'm Jane.
Designing Women, now at 10. Then, are new hearts newlyweds ready to live happily ever after?
And you're going to have to start learning to act more mature.
A new heart, now at 10:30. It's two season premieres tonight.
I'm Ray Combs for Family Feud. We thank you for watching. We will see you next time. Bye-bye.
Some of our departing families will receive beautiful jewelry finished aluminum Beautiflame butane candles for dining elegance. No wax to drip, droop, or dribble from Beautiflame Candle Company. Partisan House old-fashioned red tricycle wall sculpture reflecting Americana through the artist's personality, done in varied colored antique metal from Artisan House. Get the drop on dry eyes with the new soothing triple action formula of moisture drops, artificial tears from Bausch & Lomb. Advanced Formula Centrum, a high-potency vitamin and mineral formula with beta-carotene. Centrum, more complete from A to Zinc. Whitman's famous sampler introduces Whitman's new stack candies. Specially marked boxes are at your favorite retailers. And a member of our studio audience will receive a Hellbro's watch for all occasions. Super accurate quartz watch, beautifully styled and easy to wear from Hellbro's. From Television City in Hollywood, this is Gene Wood speaking for Family Feud, a Mark Goodson television production.